Okay. What's good, y'all? Shout out to Notification Gang for hitting the like button. The video didn't even start yet. Y'all are the best ones in it. I appreciate you anyway. Here we have another one, y'all. Of course, y'all already seen the title. I've seen the title too. I haven't seen this yet. I had somebody tag me in this on Facebook. And of course, it said the title was saying she got four kids, pro different men, and want this, that, and a third. So let's get into this, man, because this is sad, honestly. This is sad. I let me just say before the end. Let's get into it.
Yes.
Okay. You have any kids, Missy?
Care.
In home health care. You have any kids?
Yes, I got four kids.
How old are your kids?
9, 7, 4, and 1.
9, 7, 4, 1. All by different dudes. All by different dudes.
9, 7, 4. How many men?
4.
Why you not with the 1-year-old dad?
He got some problems. Like, he had too many problems. Like, he got like some crazy problems, and I had to leave my
baby by him.
Huh?
Why did you have a baby by him?
I was pregnant before I found out.
Why did you get pregnant before you find out he had problems?
Exactly.
I found out he had problems after.
You should have found out first, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Are you not with the?
But and listen to how she laughs like it's funny. I don't think this is funny. I think this is sad as hell. I honestly think this is sad as hell. But there's some type of strong. What's the word I'm looking for here? There's some type of disconnect. There's a strong disconnect between her and, well, I mean, honestly, women like her and logic. So you get with a man, sleep with him, have his baby, and all of a sudden you realize, oh, he got problems, he got issues, he can't do this, he can't do that. Kendra was like, well, you should have found that out before having a baby by him, right? And she's like, yeah, that's not, how was that, what is so funny about that? It's not funny. I didn't find this funny in the least bit. And this is the fourth child. Ladies, and listen, you know, and I'm going to try not to go too, you know, go on too long about this, but in most cases, most men that's willing to date a woman with kids, me personally, it's not that I'm fully against dating a woman with kids. I say it all the time. For me to date a woman with kids, she has to be clicking on every single cylinder, right? But men that thinks like me, we're going to think to ourselves, listen, I'm going to give you one. You had one baby, you screwed up, you messed up. It was a mistake. It was a stupid ass mistake. Okay, cool. Move on. I'll give you one. In some cases, I'll give you two. But 3 is a no. 4 is a hell no. But let's keep going because I got so much more to say.
He's a good dad, though. He's a good dad. He take care of his daughter, though.
Why are you not with the 4-year-old dad?
Because he domestic violence.
When
he likes to put his hands on people.
When did you find that out?
Great question.
Like, let me see. One day when he was drunk.
Do you think you got to get to know these men?
She just making stuff up. She guessing right now. She don't know what's going on. I think there's some type of lag going on with her mentally. That's the only thing I can think of. There has to be something because I refuse to believe that, you know, and I understand that this is a thing now. Women with 4 kids from 4 different men, 5 kids, 5 different men. There's women out here with 7 kids with 7 different damn men. And they're huge on TikTok talking about how empowering they are, how strong and independent, and all the other stupid ass stuff that they love to say. But there has to be some type of lag with her. He was abusive. He was he did a DV on her when he was one day when he got drunk. It sounds like she's just making it up. Honestly, it sounds like she's just making this stuff up. And this is the women that's in our community. This is the women that's raising our damn black children. I think she said she had a daughter. She was saying the guy with the 1-year-old. Oh, he takes care of our daughter. The daughter's gonna grow up seeing this. and probably, unfortunately, hopefully not, but unfortunately, will follow the same damn curse that the mother's damn that the mother has. It's so sad.
And better before you, I mean, have sex with them.
Thank you.
Yeah, but I've been knowing him for a long time. His mom has been knowing me since I was a kid.
So you knew he had domestic. You knew he had domestic violence problems, but you still had a baby.
No, I didn't know that he was crazy like that.
You know,
just you know, he was drunk kid. One day and he flipped out and put his hands on me.
Let's keep going. Let's keep going.
Okay, let's keep going. What do you do for? Oh, you told me, Missy. What's your zodiac sign?
I'm a Capricorn.
Okay, and where you calling me from?
Grand Rapids, Michigan.
So we got Missy Home Health Care. She's also Uber driver, Grubhub driver, a driver. Instacart, 4 kids, 9, 7, 4, and 1. A Capricorn and lives in Michigan. What kind of man are you looking for?
I'm looking for a down-to-earth man, a guy that like to travel, like to have fun, go on dates, you know?
Okay.
A family man.
How you gonna have a man doing all that and you got 4 kids, ma'am? A man that likes to travel, go out on dates, and where are you? I got so many questions, y'all. Let me just. I'm not gonna watch the full thing. It's like 10. It's like 15 minutes. 16 minutes. I'm not gonna watch this full thing. I'm gonna cut it off in another 2 minutes, and I'm gonna leave the link in the description so y'all can go back and watch this. But let's keep going, man. This is sad.
So, a family man.
Yes.
So you want? Do you want to be a part of your children's lives?
If you want to, but you know, I'm looking for like a family man. Yes.
So what'd you say to the guy? That is concerned because you do have 4 kids by 4 different men, and 1 child, 2 of your children are under 5.
Yes.
So would you say that? What'd you say to a man that might be concerned about that?
Why would they be concerned? That's what I'm trying to say. Why would they be concerned? It's like if they like me, they gotta accept
my kids too. Well, let me break it down to you. The kind of man you just described. Any man that is a provider. That knows he has to take care of things.
No, he ain't got to take care of my kids. I'm just like family man, like we go out and do something with the kids or something like that, you know?
I think this is where a lot of women are missing the mark. Do you want to get married one day?
Yeah, I want to get married one day.
Do you want to live in the same house as another man?
No, we can stay in the same house.
You want to live in
or we can have house. Separate houses.
So you want to get married, but y'all live in separate houses?
No, I said we can do either way, you know?
So you're open to getting married to a man, but he lives in a different house than you?
No, it's either way. He can either stay in his own house or he can come stay with me. I could come stay with him. It don't matter.
But you guys will all live together, correct?
Yes, I will live with him.
Okay.
So I lived with a guy before.
Right. But what I'm trying to get you to understand.
Clearly. Clearly you did.
Is when you move in with a guy, you move in also with your 4 children. So a man has to be able to provide for you and 4 other people. That's 5 people.
No, I have to take care of me and my own kids. He just got to provide for himself.
If he lives with you in the house, he's going to be providing for you. You have to have a certain house.
We can go half and half.
I know you think you have all the answers, but just hear me out so you can understand.
Kendra getting frustrated. Y'all see she said. Kendra is finally getting to understand what men has been talking about in the dating world. I'm going to probably play this for like another minute or two, but hold on. Kendra is finally starting to see what men have been talking about in the dating world. There's a strong disconnect with women that have this type of mindset. There's something missing, some type of traumatic experience, some type of daddy issues. I don't know. Obviously, I don't know her, but there's something. A strong disconnect. There's something missing with this woman. And even Kendra sitting there looking at this woman like, okay, you would want to live in separate houses and you're married? That doesn't make any sense. That should be an easy, yes, we're gonna be living together. So you expect a man to take care of you, 1, 4 kids, 5, and then him, that's 6. And then let's just assume he got maybe 2 kids. That's 8. A household of eight? Dr. Like, and I'm sure she's getting government assistance out the ass. I'm willing to bet money on it. She's getting government assistance out the damn ass as far as food stamps, as far as Section 8 housing, probably WIC and other things that she's getting in, all the other programs. She got all her kids are under 10. I know she's involved in multiple programs in her, wherever she's at. She's at Michigan. Wherever she's at in Michigan, I'm pretty sure she's involved in programs that help her kids get like book bags and school supplies and all those types of things. I know she's taking advantage of all taxpayers' money. I know it. I know it. But this is what I'm talking about. And ladies, this is what Kevin Samuels was trying to get Kendra to understand back when she was on his channel. Back when she was on his channel. And she just could not understand. Now, damn near a year and some change, this man, Kevin Samuels, died. Now she's starting to put two and two together. Now she's starting to see, yo, what the hell is going on? But let's keep going, man. I'm gonna play maybe like another minute or two, and then that's it. I'll go back and yeah. If I don't do it, just make sure y'all remind me. I'll put the full video in the description so y'all can go ahead and watch it yourself.
Things that men go in their mind. Okay. If he wants to go on vacation, it's not just you and him. It's you and four other people.
No, I can. That's four. Get a babysitter.
So you got to answer for everything. So you really honestly don't understand how a man would have to adjust for your children. You don't get that.
No, I don't get that.
This is actually the problem. Exactly. This is the problem right here, that women are not understanding. Listen, your kids are a blessing, so I want to make sure we get that clear, right?
No, Kendra about to start kissing up to her. No, ma'am, keep your foot on her neck.
But your kids are a blessing mostly to you. To anybody else coming into the picture, they have to look at your kids as, can I love on them the same? Can I provide for them the same? Do I want to live in a house with four kids?
Can I discipline them the same?
You have a one-year-old, you have a four-year-old. Let's say he's a working man and he's tired. Does he want to come home with a crying baby?
Nope.
You know, does he want to adjust his life and his in order to be with you and your children? These are some of the things that men have to think about when they are accepting a woman that comes with children. You also have four children by four different men. Does he want to deal with your four baby daddies? Does he want to live in a house with a man and their child, and now this man got an issue how he's talking to your child? Is your child going to back talk him and say, you got my real daddy? You know, does he want to deal with all that?
He ain't got to deal with four of them. He ain't got to deal with none of them.
Your kids don't live with you?
My kids live with me. I got full custody.
So if he links with you and y'all get married, he wouldn't be dealing with you?
He won't have to deal with the baby daddies.
Also, so as your kids get older, they're never going to have any relationship with your father?
What'd you say?
As your children get older, they'll never have a relationship with their father?
Yes, they got a relationship.
Okay, so let's
say, I'm just saying that the guy that I date, he ain't got to deal with the baby daddies. You're
saying that now, but let's say your one-year-old turns 8 years old and he's mad at your new man, and then he goes to the biological father and says, this man was talking crazy to me, he ain't my daddy. Now the biological father calls your man and says, yo, you better make sure you don't talk to my child this way.
No,
the bottom line,
they ain't gonna do that. I got my baby daddies in check.
Oh, your baby daddies are in check?
Yes.
Okay,
we gotta understand this.
Kendra, done. I'm done. There's some type of disconnect with this woman, and I hope she gets the help that she gets. I pray to God she gets some type of help. Honestly and truthfully, I do. Beautiful woman. Clearly, she ain't got no problem getting a damn man. She got four damn kids. Obviously, she ain't got no type of problem whatsoever getting a man. But the point of the matter is this. How many of those men were actual good guys? You had the last, well, she didn't really get too much into details about, but the one-year-old, the man that you got a one-year-old with, you said he just ain't got it together. He just off, or whatever the case may be. She ain't going to details about it. I wish Kendra would have asked more about the details, but whatever. The two-year-old, the guy was abusive. What about the, I'm sorry, not two-year-old. She said 1, 4, 7, and 9. So the four-year-old baby daddy was abusive. What about the seven-year-old baby daddy? What about the nine-year-old baby daddy? Y'all gonna look me in my eye and tell me that this was what this woman was not a problem in none of those four relationships. Y'all are going to look me in my eye. Let me look at the camera. Y'all are going to look me in my eyes, I'm going to say eyes, and tell me that this woman was not an issue in any of the four relationships. I say all that to say this, man, because, you know, again, like I said towards the beginning of the video, it's just sad. So many of our Black sisters is in this types of situation, these predicaments, and there's almost no hope. Honestly, if I'm being brutally honest, there's damn near no type of hope. I want to finish this video, but I'm in my mind, I'm thinking, yo, do I want to keep going? Because I let's listen for like another. If I can take it, let's listen to another minute of it, man. Because I'm ready to go. I'm done.
So they call me and say, hey, I want to see the baby this time. Then I'll bring the baby. You know.
Your children are.
They don't just come to my house and pop up like that.
Your children are 9, 7, 4, and 1. You have a lot more years to deal with these men. You don't know how it's going to turn out.
Exactly.
Well, I'm ready to date.
Of course you're ready to date because you.
Oh, I'm not surprised. You ready for somebody to jump up in and bust in that kootenai? I already know. She ready for baby dad number 5. She ain't learned not nan lesson. She did not learn not one lesson. This is scary. And she is raising children. She said she already meant to say she had one daughter. I wish Kendra would have said how many boys and how many girls. But she we know she has a daughter. That's one. Where do y'all, and I hate to say this about a Black child, but where do y'all think that Black child is going to end up in the next 15 years? Being raised up on a woman like this. And I mean that with the utmost respect. Be honest. This is scary. Oh, I got full custody of my kids. Yeah, because your four baby daddies, they don't want nothing to do with the damn kids, probably letting on with you. What is her definition of taking care of kids, of the kids? She said a one-year-old baby daddy takes care of the kids. But you said that the one-year-old ain't got it together like that. So what is her definition of take care? Just coming through and seeing them seeing the child every day or every couple of days or something like that? This is scary. And this is why we need these types of spaces in the Black community, number one. This is the reason why we need these types of spaces. This is why we need somebody to talk to our damn black women and Black men. Mainly Black women, because a lot of them are so damn lost. It is scary.
You want companionship. Everyone wants that.
I don't really care about companionship. You know, dating is like going out, having fun, you know.
Well, how is that working for you, Missy? Are you getting a lot of opportunities?
I was dating somebody last year, but, you know, I've just been focused on work and stuff.
Okay. All right, so let's keep going. What was the last question? Oh, let's do...
Honestly, bro, she should be focused on working and her kids. She shouldn't even be worried about dating. And if you're going to date, you need to go back to one of your four baby daddies and make it work some way, somehow. Some way, somehow. You don't got to go with the one that's abusive. I'm not saying that. But you got to make it work with one of your four baby daddies. Because this is crazy. Any man, I'm telling you right now, ladies, hopefully you're not in a situation like her. Any man that sees her and knows she got four kids from four different dudes, they thinking the same thing. Yo, listen, let me go ahead and get this nut and keep it moving. That's a fact, but let's keep going.
Does the guy got to make a certain amount of money?
Like 50K in a year.
Okay. Do you want more kids?
No.
So you don't want more kids?
I don't have my tools tied, but I'm just saying I don't want more kids right now.
You should have had your tools tied after the second one. You should have your tubes tied now.
And you want to get married one day?
Yes. You asked me that, yes.
Yeah, so you want a man that already has kids then, right?
He can have kids or he can want kids. If we get married, I will have a kid with him.
So now in order for you to have a baby, you got to be married?
Yes.
Why didn't you have that requirement before you had your other four kids?
Thank you.
I was going to get married to my first baby daddy, but he backed out. He was scared to get married.
And what about the other three baby daddies?
I told you the other one is in life. He doing life in prison. So.
Oh, one of your children's dads. Why is he in prison for life?
Because he got himself messed up with something. Somebody had died or something, and at a hotel, somebody got shot, and he was with somebody that shot somebody, so they gave him life in prison.
Murder, basically.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Missy, Ucha.
As it is. Thank you, Kendra. You took the words out of my goddamn mouth. I'm thinking like, goddamn.
Does this guy have to look a certain way?
No, just sexy.
He has to be sexy.
Yep.
Let's do the Kendra cam.
Okay, let me see. How can I do this?
She had to leave her place because her place was getting so loud with the damn kids. Imagine, fellas, you coming home after a long ass 10, 12, 14 hour shift at work. You tired, you had a long ass day. And if you live in Florida, you probably sweaty as hell because it's 110 degrees outside. And then happen to come home to hear that from kids that's not even yours. I'll be pissed the hell off. Why I gotta hear these damn kids? I'm trying to come home to silence. You know what I'm saying? Get in the shower, have something to eat, lay up with my baby. And then that's it. But imagine having to deal with that every damn day for the rest of your life, assuming that you will date a woman like this.
It's hard to do this.
We can't see your legs, honey.
Well, let me sit it somewhere else, because I don't know where to sit it at. Well, let me get my daughter to do it. Come here, Nye. Come and do this.
So she obviously has another older daughter, because she said her other daughter is one, and now she's calling another daughter to call. So maybe the other daughter is either 4 or 7 or 9.
Hold this.
Okay, we see. Bring the phone down. Okay, we see you, Missy. We see you, baby girl.
Is she in a hotel? That's the thing that they use in the hotel to bring your bags up and stuff.
Missy,
I'm here.
What was your last relationship, honey?
Last year.
The 1 year old.
You don't have to answer, but I'm gonna ask. When's the last time you was intimate with someone?
6 months ago.
Okay. What are 3 flaws you think you have to work on?
Being patient. Let me see. Just being patient.
You only have 1 flaw.
Yep.
You sure?
Yes.
That's your
picking
final
the right
answer.
Guy.
Huh?
Picking the right guy.
Picking the right guy. Yep. Picking the right guy.
That should have been the first one.
Why do you think you're single, Missy?
I think I'm single because I run to a lot of mommy boys. I don't get out a lot, so, you know. Can't find the right guy. And
clearly you don't get out a lot, ma'am. Your ass got 4 damn kids. What you get out and do what? What you mean? You it sound like you've been getting out enough.
I'm shy, so that's why I think I'm single.
Okay.
You ain't that shy. Please stop it.
Why would a guy be lucky to be with you?
Because you know, I like to explore the world and I'm a fun person. And I like to cook and just like to have fun and stuff.
Okay, she likes to have fun. Missy, what's the age range you want to date? Or how old are you, Missy?
I'm 32.
32. You're 32. What's the age range you want to date?
30 to 50.
Okay. Okay. Does he have to be in, and you're calling me from Michigan. Does he have to be in Michigan?
No, he ain't got to be in Michigan. I'm ready to travel.
Okay, you're ready. To travel. Let's do it. Missy, 32. She works at home health care, also Uber driver, Lyft driver, Instacart, Grubhub, 4 kids, 9, 7, 4, and 1.
And this is the thing, because I mean she's done now. She's just gonna ask for a few more last little questions to hook her up with some guy. My thing is this, Kendra don't be paying attention. It looks like she's in a hotel. I would have been like, yo, why are you in a hotel right now? Do you have a reliable, first of all, do you have reliable transportation, number one? But do you have your own spot, your own place? Or are you guys just living in and out of hotels and motels? Because again, like I said, that your priorities, man, I'm done. I'm done. I'm done. I didn't even want to react to the full video, y'all. I apologize. I am sorry. I want y'all to comment down below and let me know what y'all thought about this video. I'm done. I'm out. I'm done.